Sangeeta Chauhan. I'm from Hindustan University, and I'm going to explain critical section problem. So what is critical section? It is a part of a program where the shared resources are shared by different processes. For example, if we have two processes, P1 and P2, it is having some program. Main some program is written, okay, some instructions are there. Similarly, in process P2, some instructions are written, okay. So some portion will be there, that main P2 and P1 is having some area where both the program is containing same resources. So let's see is the resource which is carrying in both the process P1 and P2. So these both the C variables are containing process P2. So what we will do, we will keep this value in separate section, which is called critical section, okay, because we are keeping the main resources, the same resources, in a separate place. So this is called critical section. Rest of the instructions are called non-critical sections, okay. These are called non-critical sections. So what is critical section problem? Problem means what is problem, huh? Na? So what you will do, that when we have more than process, more than one process, two processes, n number of processes, so if same section, critical section they are going to use, so they have a problem, because which process has to come first, which has to come after, so that is problem, okay. For example, like P1, P2, we have two processes, and P1 and P2 both want to use the same resource called C. Okay, same resource called C, let it is 6. So when P1 will go to the critical section and it will ask, it wants to use the critical section, what it will do if it is incrementing. Here it is doing incrementation, so it will change the value 6 to 7. And when it will go to the second process, so what it will do? It will again change the process if it is doing C minus minus. So it will do what? It will again put the value 6. So we are using same resources, we are getting different outputs, wrong outputs we are getting. So to reduce this, to solve this, what we are doing, we are creating one part, means section, okay, so that entry will be only one, so that each process can come at a time, and then another process can come single, means separate, individual times they can come. So what we are doing to solve that, every time only one process can come at a time. So what we will do, we will make one section called entry section and another section called exit section. So whenever the process P1, any process will come, it will first enter into the enter section, then only it can go to the critical section. So for example, if you are entering in your room, that room is your critical section. You have some resources, you want to go inside your room. So what you will do, you will go inside, you will take the resources. How you will go? Until you unlock your critical section, that room, you cannot go. So first you have to enter into that entry section, then only you can enter in your room, and then you can, when you will go out, means this is what? This is called unlock portion. This is called unlock. So this is, you will unlock the critical section. After unlocking, you will go to the critical section. Whatever you want to use in that critical section, you use that. After using, you can go out. Okay. So when you entered in your room, you use your room resources, you have taken all the resources, then after going out, you should exit, because it is your room, you should keep exit, okay. So after room, you can, after coming out of the room, you should get out of the room, Anna, then lock the door. To solve that critical section is used by only one resources, only one process can use this resources, what you have to do, there are many solutions to solve that. It is not mandatory that given solution you can use, you create your own resources and you can use that. So many problems are there, Peterson solution, semaphore, monitor, these are the solutions for the critical section. You can create your own solution and then you can implement that, okay. To use critical section problem, we have to follow some criteria that this should be we have to keep in mind before solving any or before giving some solutions to anything. So there are main three section solutions are there, not solution. Three criteria are there to solve this critical section problem. These two are called. These are important. This is not very important. If you will remove this, no problem. But if you will take in criteria, then it will be also good. Means, so what is mutual exclusion? Mutual exclusion means if many processes are giving and every time only one process is coming into the critical section and using the resource and getting out, this is called mutual exclusion. Means one at a time. Every process come one at a time, not more than one. So this is called mutual exclusion. Then progress. Progress is what that if you have two processes P1 and P2, and this is critical section. P1 also want to use critical section, but P2 don't want to use critical section. So what P1 wants to, but P2 don't want. So what it is doing? It is not executing, but it is not allowing P2 to get into the critical section. It is refusing that, don't go. So example for this round robin, you know round robin, one process will come, another process will get chance, again it will be in circular loop. So like P1 will come, it will use critical section, then P2 will come, it will use the critical section, P3 will come, again it will use the critical section, again it will go to the P1. But what is the problem that if P2 don't want to use critical section, so what it will do, it is not going to the critical section and it is saying P1 that if you will not use, that means P1 will also not go because it is not going, no. So it is restricting P1 also because it is not executing. P should also execute, then only P will go, no. So it is called progress, okay. Bounded time means you have a process P1 and P2, okay. P1 want to use critical section, P2 also wants to use critical section, both wants to use critical section. But what is happening, P1 is going into the critical section, it is executing, again it is coming after execution, again P1 is getting chance to critical to use the critical section, again it is getting exit, and then again means again P1 is only getting chance to execute the critical section, P2 is not getting chance to use critical section. So this is called time bounded. Means it should not be happening in program that P1 only one resource can continuously using us the critical section for infinity time. That another resource should also, the another process should also get the chance to use the critical section. This is called time bounded.